In order for us to actually find love, a part of us must die. A part of us needs to die, because it's not love. Usually, it's something based in fear. So that is what St. Francis was meaning when he said, it is in dying to self that we are born to eternal life. It is when the personality gets in the way. It is when our attention and our thoughts, feelings, perceptions become our circumstances and events in our lives, and we start operating from a place of fear. And we don't even know we're doing it. And this is the destructive power of the personality running riot, running on subconscious. A lot of the work we do is teaching people how to wake up, how to be present again, how to focus and be mindful. And there's a massive, massive difference between knowing what to do and actually doing it. That is the secret for many people's success. Love really is the energy of the soul. Love heals the personality, and compassion and gratitude along with it. And we've often overcomplicated this thing, and this is where the sacred texts and the wisdom traditions come in, is that we need to return to love. That's how we're going to get through the mental health crisis and every other epidemic, pandemic that ever comes, by returning to self. We've all heard of the power of love, but I think we underestimate it, especially when it comes to healing ourselves. An authentically powered person really lives in love. It's IQ, EQ, which is your emotional quotient. And that makes you live a completely different life to a person whose heart is hardened. And when your heart's hardened, a part of you needs to die. Compassion and kindness really have become pivotal to people understanding that to heal a personality, which is a mask, it's something inauthentic, that you need to bring your authenticity to the party. The truth will set you free, and that's the most powerful thing I've ever learned. The truth will set you free. That's one of the most powerful things I've ever seen people apply. It's almost as if when they know that, they start to just surrender, put their hands up, and things begin to change literally straight away, like a satora or an instant awakening. Generally, it's a process, yes, but people do change their lives in an instant. You know, often we get a wake-up call, and it's being mindful, attentive, focused enough to hear that wake-up call. And we respond to that call with an open heart and with love. If we respond to it from the personality, which is all our thoughts, perceptions, feelings that we've ever built up, every experience that we've ever had to protect ourselves from, is a place where we operate from and we don't even know it. And we call these your 10 ego insurgents. They really need to make way for love, which is connection, gratitude, courage, wisdom, and so on. And we found these 10 pathways back to your authentic self, a self that is really, really rooted in love. This is really, really good news. It's science, it's psychology, human science, but it's also spirituality. You know, the desert fathers and the mystics and monks have been telling us this for centuries. And what we get to see now is how all of that wisdom is starting to play out. And when you have a disordered personality, you're going to have a disordered life, a disordered relationships, disordered career, finances, and so on. Eventually, that disorder is going to seep into everything. So we return to a full dimension of wellness when we become authentic once again. Some of us have never found our authenticity, and we can really use that as a wake-up call. If we're suffering, we need to take it as a wake-up call and start to actually change. You don't read, listen to podcasts, you can do all you like. If you're not really there authentically, it's not going to change a damn thing. We've found that there is nothing that cannot be healed by love, especially the personality, especially the masks that we've put on to protect ourselves. So for us, hell is empty. You know, I keep saying that to people, and it's good news once again. How can you blame somebody who is frightened and fearful and operating with a closed heart with no emotional quotient whatsoever, or the emotions of, you know, a 10-year-old? So what we've got to understand is that the road back to health is the road through personality, shattering the masks, lifting the veil of ignorance that we once lived under, and finding our true selves. It's almost too simple to teach at times. How we can actually start to wake up is starting to notice. Noticing is a gift. We can notice when we become judgmental, when we become codependent, when we close off, when we become a rescuer or a victim, or a persecutor for that matter. We must wake up and change something. And that's where the walk is different from the talk. Actually doing change is very, very difficult for most people until they begin. This is why it's the journey back to sacred self, the journey home, really. We catch ourselves with these emotional, impulsive reactions, and we start to separate the false from the true, the authentic from the inauthentic. And you will see the frightened parts of yourself reacting with fear very quickly. And, you know, to know thy enemy is to know the masks that you've worn since you were a child. And if there is suffering, if there's depression, pain, anxiety, stress, or simply if your life is not working for you, that is a call that you need to answer. It's time to wake up and start taking these calls, taking accountability, and moving back towards your authentic self. It really is a self based in love, and there's nothing more powerful than love. How do we get to love? We get there through compassion. We get there through kindness. We get there through patience. We get there through the 3-second rule of pausing before we respond. That's how we get there. One random act at a time. Anything that is not love in us must die. This is the journey of life. And it just shows us that something is going on, something good. The journey is to remove everything that is not based in love. And when we start to remove these things, we really start to live deeply, profoundly. We don't just heal, which is something we do again and again and again. We transform. In other words, we go above the form, the silhouette, the mask that we once wore. And that is spiritual awakening. There is a spiritual solution, which means there's a solution inside. God, self, and other. And it's all going on around us. It's all good news. We've just got to listen. We teach people through the paradigm process how to manage their energy, how to manage their emotions. Thoughts, feelings, and actions are always going somewhere. They're creating you. And in so doing, that creates an external environment. But you're not the environment, thank goodness. So you can recreate. And I think this is a necessary part of life. A first half and a second half. And in the first half, we create out of fear and we create a mess. Most of us have a history of some kind of disorder, dis-ease, trauma, anxiety, and so on and so forth. And really, it's part of the journey. But staying there is not the journey at all. When you open your heart center, your EQ, you really start to move into heart, brain, body coherence. And when everything starts to work together, it becomes far, far easier. And we accomplish far, far greater things than we ever thought possible, probably at the beginning. We use our physiology, our psychology, our emotions, and our spirituality together. We need to show up fully, and this is showing up wholeheartedly for ourselves in our life. Now, when we show up and move towards love out of fear, move from powerlessness back to a real authentic sense of the power of love, we are naturally kinder. We are naturally more forgiving. And now you can see how the cycle starts to perpetuate itself. So love really is an energy that is moving, living, and breathing through you. And all you've got to do is choose it again and again and again. And it's love is something that you practice. It's really not an idea in our heads. It's a real, living, powerful thing. I think we've got to pick it up and put it on like a coat. And that's the paradigm shift. That's the shift from an ego defensive self to a sacred self or authentic self, is going, I don't have to do this anymore. I don't have to be impulsive. I don't have to over defend myself. And if you think something of me that I don't like, that is not my business. And of course, we can understand how beautiful the world will be once we're all just managing our own business, increasing the amount of time we spend chasing love, pursuing it and practicing it is science. The more time we spend in those loving emotions, gratitude and so on, we're then going to get the dopamine responses. So our actual body is going to start to change. Our whole pharmacy, which is the most powerful pharmacy on the planet, which is the one inside, is literally going to start to shift when we spend more time on gratitude, kindness, and just keeping that heart open with empathy. But when I'm impatient, judgmental, frustrated, I'm then going to build gray matter in a totally different part of my brain. And those dopamine responses are going to be so lacking that I'm going to look to medication from the outside to now push me from the doldrums of my survival mind through towards, my hippocampus, towards enlarging it with love, which is what happens, which can then send my thoughts, feelings, and actions to my prefrontal cortex where I can be creative again. So staying in a creative center more of the day is going to create something good. Staying in a survival mind is not going to bring much for us to thrive on. Well, the key here is that love is contagious. So it starts with the self. Any journey that we go on starts with me and flips upside down into we. It starts with the self, and then it spreads like wildfire through other people into our relationships. That's what empathy is. It's care, love for other people, because it's overflowing inside of us and we've got enough of it to give away, which is what I find the great shift is at the moment in the world. It's starting to run more and more on love, and people are far, far more tolerant of each other than they've ever been. It's difficult. The conversations we're having in the world today are difficult. They're about racism, transgender, the left, the right, the middle, the up, the down. They're difficult, but we're getting through it, and we're shaking hands and hugging and moreover accepting each other at the end of the day. So love becomes contagious. We move from self-loathing, self-indulgence, selfishness through to self-love. The love that we practice inside is something that is going to change the world. And that really is any process, the 12 steps, the 4 agreements, whatever it's going to be. It's first building the self, understanding that there's a true self that can really change everything. So when you change the way you look at things, the things you look at actually change, including the person or the personality looking back at you in the mirror.